Would you know what to do if someone suffered a heart attack at your workplace?
KMBC9's Bev Chapman has the story of how CPR and a defibrillator machine made a life and death difference.
The American Heart Association says 92% of people who suffer a heart attack outside a hospital will die. Fortunately, Gene Rourke here in Olathe did not become part of that statistic.
And I'm living proof. There are survivors. There are survivors.
Gene Rourke had no idea his heart was in trouble, no prior symptoms. In fact,
I'd just been to my doctor a month before and had blood work done and physical, and just one of those things that just happened so fast.
Happened while he was on the job here at Royal Metal Industries.
And I got to right here, and my chest hurt, and down I went.
What happened next would rewrite the story of his life. His co-workers responded with the same kind of precision they apply every day on the job, only better. It started with plant manager Tony Taylor.
But I started the CPR first, and then I called Will.
Tony was given CPR. He asked me to take over. I took over, give first aid.
And the same person that called me went to go get Margie and the ADE machine.
I just automatically grabbed it, ran out here, and went, dropped down to my knees.
The rapid response kit hangs in Margie's office. It's an automated external defibrillator the company's had for 2 years.
It was scary. I mean, we've never had to use it before, and it's just something you can't explain.
They were 45 seconds away from a second shock when help arrived.
It just happened so quick. Everything was so quick. Fell right in line, just like the training that we had.
When you see one of your coworkers go down, it's hard, you know, it really hurts, and you just try and do as much as you can.
We're a big family here, and it worked out good.
Gene returned to work 2 weeks later with a stent in his left aorta. He is beyond grateful and plans to do something to prove it.
After what happened to me, I'm going to take it up on my own to learn it, and the AED also, because maybe I can pass that good fortune on to somebody else, you know.
The American Heart Association says people who already have CPR training should retrain every 2 years to keep their skills current. To find out how you can do that, log on to our website. In Olathe, I'm Bev Chapman, KMBC 9 News.